Hello, welcome to Evan Singh Academy. This is another session of quadratic equations. Let me discuss few more questions on the basis of what we have discussed. Solving the equations by method of factorization. This is the topic what we are discussing right now. This is the question and topic. So the following situations we have discussed in the previous session, and in this session we will discuss this another type of questions. Where AC is negative, B is positive, and this is a negative. So consider the second question here. X square plus 5x minus 6 is equal to 0. This is the question. Let me discuss this. Product of here 1 and minus 6 would be minus 6. Here AC is minus 6. AC is negative, right? AC is negative. B is positive. So bigger factor would be positive or a smaller factor would be negative. Now B, that is 5, has to be rearranged or split in two terms such that their product would be minus 6. Product of two terms is minus 6. It means one term must be bigger and a smaller term, one term must be smaller than 5. So here product is minus 6 and we have to arrange this. So product of minus 6 can be arranged at minus 6 into 1 or 1 into minus 6, that can be also possible, or 2 into minus 3 or minus 3 into 2, that is also possible, you know, bigger or smaller, we can do that, like. So 1 minus 6 into 1, that is one term, minus 6 into 1 is also minus 6. 1 into minus 6 is also minus 6. 2 into 3, minus 3 is also minus 6. And minus 3 into 2 is also minus 6. But which one of them to be selected? This is a question, and that is I want to tell you, because you need to learn this. Many students I have seen that they are not able to understand that how I can break this middle term. So that is why all these phenomena I am dealing here again and again. Try to understand this. How to break this? And this AC, product AC, product of first and third, that are to be break in such a way that their sum would be 5, but their product is minus 6. So here product is minus 6, their sum must be equal to 5. So can I write minus 6 plus 1? What would be sum? Minus 5. But we need some 5, so that is rejected. Minus 1 and plus 6, minus 1 and plus 6, that is another one. Can I write here, or even I can write here, this is the 6, positive term, bigger term, smaller term, I am writing like this. And now bigger term and smaller term like this. So bigger term is 6 and a smaller term is like this. I can write here again, because I am writing always bigger term first and a smaller term second. So 3 into minus 2, that can be also written. So bigger term this side, why I have written like this? Although there is no difference, but I have written here bigger first and a smaller second. So on the same pattern I am writing here also. So bigger 6, a smaller minus 1. 6 into minus 1 would be also minus 6. 1 into minus 6 would be also minus 6. 2 into minus 3 will be also minus 6. 3 into minus 2 will be also minus 6. But their sum must be equal to 5. So 6 plus minus 1. Is it 5? Yes. So that is the appropriate one. You can say, why not next one? Because their sum is equal to minus 5. Their sum is minus 1. And their sum is 1. And their sum is 5. So this one is the one which we wanted, because sum should be 5. So first factor to be selected, and these three are rejected completely. These three are rejected. So some possibility may come out. While you will find the product of AC, some possibility of the factors may come out. You have to select those which sum is equal to B. Sum is equal to B. And rest of them can be rejected. So with bit practice, you will be able to do it directly. No need to write all this, but you can do that. Now, how to deal with such question? Now, what I should write? I should write x square bigger factor must be equal to how much? 6. So I can write here 6x. A smaller factor must be equal to minus 1. So minus 1x, that is minus x, minus 6 is equal to 0. I can write here, I can took x common from this. I can take x common from this. So what will remain? X square. That is nothing else but x into x. So if I took x common from this, so what happened? X will remain and now 6 will left here. If I took minus 1 common, x plus 6 will left because negative sign has been taken common. So inside bracket, the sign will be changed. This is the remarkable things. Please make sure that you have got this point and you remember this, that whenever negative sign is being taken common, then inside bracket, the sign will change. Got it? Now, if I took x plus 6 common from both the sides, what will come? X minus 1 is equal to 0. So, x plus 6 is equal to either 0 or x minus 1 is equal to 0. So, x is equal to minus 6 or x is equal to 1. So, solution set will be minus 6 and 1. Two members are there. Two answers came. One minus 6, other is minus 1. So I hope you got it. This one also. Right now? Need to explain once again? Okay, let me explain once again. This is x square plus 5x minus 6. First of all, we should find the product of this. That is minus 6. Now we have to split this. But because it is a positive sign, if I break two positive terms in two positive terms, their product cannot be negative. Product will be negative if and only if one of them is bigger, positive, and other factor is negative. So positive, because the final sign is positive, so bigger factor must be positive, a smaller factor must be negative. So I did this, 6 into minus 1 is minus 6, 1 into minus 6 is minus 6, 2 into minus 3 is also minus 6, 3 into minus 2 is also minus 6. But what the factors which will satisfy the condition that their sum is equal to 5. So 6 plus minus 1 is equal to 5. 6 plus minus 1 is equal to 5. So this is what the quotient plus. Plus must be equal to 5. Sum of these two terms is equal to 5. That satisfying only first condition, and therefore first condition is right answer and rest of three is wrong one. So we can reject them. Now I can took x square bigger term, 6x is positive and x is negative. 6x minus 6 is 5x and 6x multiplied by x will be 6x square, whereas minus 6 multiplied by x square is also minus 6x square. So both of them are same. Now if I took x common, x plus 6. If I took 1 common, x plus 6 will remain. And again if I take x plus 6 common from both, this there will be x left, there will be minus 1. So x plus 6, x minus 1 is equal to 0. X plus 6 is equal to 0 or x minus 1 is equal to 0, because you know product of two linear factors would be 0, two or more linear factors will be equal to 0 if and only if at least one of them is equal to 0. But we don't know which one of them is 0. So we can take the liberty of assuming this, that either this will be 0 or that will be 0, and by finding this, x is equal to minus 6 and x is equal to 1. So there are two possibilities in which it will be 0. And actually we are finding zeros of the equation, the value of x for which the equation vanishes. So x is equal to minus 6 if I would put here, that will be 0. If I put x is equal to 1 here, then it will be also 0. You may check it. Just to satisfy yourself, you may check it. If I put here x is equal to minus 6, minus 6 whole square plus 5 into minus 6, minus 6. Minus 6 whole square is 36. 6, 5 is 30 minus 6. Minus 30 minus 6 is minus 36. And 36 minus 36 is 0. So minus 6 satisfies the equation. Also, if I put 1, then it will also satisfy the equation. 1 square plus 5 into 1 minus 6. 1 square is 1. 5 into 1 is 5 minus 6. 1 plus 5 is 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. So both of them are the value of x which will satisfy the equation, which will make the equation 0, which will vanish the equation at 0, and therefore they are called zeros of the equation. The value of x which will make turn out the whole equation at 0, so it is called zeros of the equation. So I hope you got it, right? So let us consider the third type of. So here I can write question number 3. 2x square plus 3x minus 9 is equal to 0. Here product of AC is negative, right? And the middle term is also negative. I can write here minus. Middle term is also negative. Now what will happen in that case? So in that case, product of AC is negative. Think. Product B is also negative. So both the factors are negative, but bigger one should be negative and a smaller one should be positive. Now find the product. Here AC is minus 18. What are the possible factors of minus 18? Let me write here. 18 into minus 1, that is 18, right? And that can be 18 into minus 1. Or minus 18 into 1, that is also possible. Or you may write here the same thing, 1 into minus 18, that is also possible. So what to write? 18 into minus 1 or 1 into minus 18, or it will be in the same pattern. You will write here minus 1 into minus 18, that is also possible. So you can write anyway, either one of them term will be negative. So whenever you learn all these things, then no need to write these two terms. You can write only one term. Either this side negative or that side negative. So let me write only one instead of writing two. It will reduce the effort. It will reduce your calculation also. So 18 into minus 1, right? Like this. And if I write here, 18 can be 9 into 2. Right into 2. It can be also written 6 into 3, right? Anything else? Can you write it? No. So, I instead of writing 6 terms, I have written here only 3 pairs. Right? Na? Otherwise, if I took minus plus together, then there will be 6 opportunity taking care of which one will be minus and which one will be plus. Now, we will think that whether their sum or difference is equal to minus 3. So 18 plus 1 or 18 minus 1 will not be equal to minus 3. 9 plus 2 or 9 minus 2 will not be equal to minus 3. 6 plus 3, 9, and 6 minus 3 will be 3 with negative sign. Yes, that is possible. So if I take this as a negative sign and this is a positive sign, then that would be minus 3. So the two way, don't be confused. Try to understand. If you are want to understand like that, then you can do that also. But if you, after some time, definitely you have to come at across this point. 18 into minus 1 or 1 into minus 18 or 6 into minus 3 or minus 3 minus 6 into 3 like this, or 9 into minus 2 or minus 9 into 2. These are the 6 possibility. If you are confused with the previous method, you should start practicing with this and then you will come back to that. Here the sum is minus 17. That is not possible, so this is rejected. Here sum is minus 17. That is also rejected. 6 minus 3 is positive 3. That is also rejected. Minus 6 plus 3 is minus 3. That is accepted. 9 minus 2 is 7. That is rejected. Minus 9 plus 2 is minus 7. That is also rejected. So either you can write like this. If you are weak, you are not able to analyze this quickly. So you start writing like this. And for after some time, whenever you will be familiar with that process, definitely you write in 3 steps. And later on, after some more practice, no need to write even three steps. You can write only one step and you will be able to write answers quickly. So here, SA is minus 18 and B is minus 3. So which one to be taken? This one to be taken. Even this step is no need to write it. This is a rejected step. No need to write it here. It is not necessary to write here also. This step in solution, no need to write. You can do it in roughly. You can make it somewhere else. And you can write here directly. 2x squared minus 6x plus 3x minus 9 is equal to 0. Right? So this is what we have to write here. Now, 2x squared minus 6x. What can be taken maximum common? 6 is coefficient of 2. So can I take 2 common? Yes. And x can be taken common because x is present in both. So if I would have taken 2x common, then what is left here? From 2x square, I have taken 2x common. So amount left is x only. Here, because x has been already taken common, and out of 6, 2 has been taken common. Taking common means divide by that number. So 6 divided by 2, that is 3 left. Right now? Now think like out of 6 I have taken 2 common, then 4 will be left. Like if you have 4 chocolate and 2 I have taken, then 4 chocolate left with you. Don't think like that. It is a multiplication. So we want to find common as a multiplier. So it will divide the numbers, right now? So 6 divided by 2, that would be 3. If I would have taken 3 common from this, x is left, and again 3 has taken common, means 9 to be divided by 3, and 9 to be divided by 3 is 3 only, that is 0. So again, if I would have taken 3 common, x minus 3 from both the sides common, what is left here? 2x. What is left there? 3, and that would be equal to 0. In that way, either x minus 3 is equal to 0 or 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. So either x is equal to 3 or x is equal to minus 3 by 2. So solution said again will be what? 3 and minus 3 by 2. So two answers came here, and that are 3 and minus 3 by 2. One positive roots and another one is negative roots. So I hope you got it. First you have to find this, then split this in two terms so that their sum will be equal to this and their product will be equal to product of these two. 9 into minus 2 is minus 18x squared, minus 6x multiplied by 3x is also minus 18x squared. This is the beauty of this concept. You have to deal with this, and thereafter I have taken 2x common. So 2x here, once if you take 2x common, here x will left, here 3 will left. If you took 3 common, x will left, 3 will left. Taking common means dividing the numbers. Taking 2 common means divide 6 by 2. Got it now? Taking 3 common means divide 9 by 3. Got it? Now x minus 2 can be taken common from this. X minus 3, and x minus 3 can be taken common from this. So what is left? If I had taken this thing common, then 2x will left. And if I had taken this thing common, then 3 will left. So 2x plus 3 is left. And now these are the two linear factors. And as we had discussed, product of two linear factors is equal to 0 if and only if one of them is equal to 0. So either x minus 3 is equal to 0 or 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 3 or x is equal to minus 3 by 2. So there are two solutions which can be derived from this. I hope you got it, right? Okay. So let us discuss fourth type of question. Fourth type of question where AC is positive and B is negative. 4x square and this is minus 10x and this is minus 8. Minus 8 is equal to 0. Like that. This is the situation. If I have written But both of them are divisible by 2, so I should change one of them. 7, 4 is 28. So I can write here 7. And this is 14 into 9, 2. Because this is negative. So, if I take 6, 14. X square minus 8x I have written here, and this is something like 12, like this. Here coefficient of this two, let me discuss this, because I am generating the questions at that instant of time and writing this, so question can be anything. If I would multiply this two, what will be that? This is negative minus 12, AC is minus 12, right? And here B is also minus 8. So what will be the possible factor of minus 12? 12 into minus 1, minus 12 into 1, 6 into minus 2, minus 2, 6 into 2, right? 4 into minus 3 and minus 4 into 3. These are the possible factors, right? You have learned this. Now, what to deal with this? Which one of them is best octet? 12 plus minus 1 cannot be equal to minus 8. So it is 11, so this is rejected. Minus 12 plus 1 is also rejected because it is a minus 11 only. 6 minus 2 is also rejected. 6 minus 2 is minus 4, right? The other possibility, if I would reject here minus 6 because product is negative, so what will happen? Minus 6 plus, wait. That will be some other questions. Here, that is not a fourth type of question, but here something different will come. If I would have written here positive, then this will come like plus 12. Otherwise, it will be minus 12. Then this question has some other factors. It is not possible to write in factors here. Because here, something different value will come. Direct factors is not possible. This is also a type of question, don't worry about that. This is product sum is minus 4, not possible. 4 into 3, 1, that is also not possible. Minus 4 into 3 is not possible. So factors are possible, but not in that way. So how to deal with such question? How can you make the factor of that question? So to deal with such question, you have to, there is no other option except this, that you go with the completing the perfect square and find the factors of that. How to deal with such questions? If x square minus 8x, half of coefficient of it, that is 4 square you need to add and 4 square you need to subtract, minus 12 is equal to 0. So that can be written x minus 4 whole square minus 16 minus 12 is equal to 0. X minus 4 whole square minus 28 is equal to 0. X minus 4 whole square minus root 28 whole square is equal to 0. Can I write 28 as root 28 whole square? Root 2 whole square is 2. Root 3 whole square is 3. So root 28 whole square is also root 28. Right? So I can write a square minus b square. Remember this? What is this? A square minus b square? You have studied in class 6. A plus b, a minus b. So I can write here x minus 4 plus root 28, or x minus 4 minus root 28 is equal to 0. So I can write here, more simplified way, I can write 28 as 4 into 7. So this will be also minus 4 into 7. Can I write like this? So it will be x minus 4 plus 2 root 7 and x minus 4 minus 2 root 7 is equal to 0. So these are the two factors. It means either one of them is equal to 0. So x is equal to 4 minus 2 root 7 and x is equal to 4 plus 2 root 7. So there are two answers, and solution set will be what? 4 minus 2 root 7 and 4 plus 2 root 7. So these are the two answers. which can be generated. Okay, so have some time. Okay, so let me discuss one more question. One more question of the last category, what we have not discussed. Eventually we have not written in that format. So let me discuss the fourth type of question. And what is this fourth type of question? Question number 5. Although this is a question number 5, but this is a fourth type of question. So here AC is positive, but B is negative. So the product is x 2x square or even x square minus 8x, right? X square and plus 12, that is equal to 0. This is the question. Simple question. Here AC is positive. So product of these two is positive, 12. So this is a positive, right? And B is negative. B is minus 8, that is negative. You got it? Okay. Now, what to do? So this 12 can be factorized as, what is the possible factors of 12? That is 12 into 1 or 1 into 12 into 1, because product is positive, or 6 into 2 or 2 into 6 or 3 into 4 or 4 into 3. These are the possibility. Also, the product of two positive terms is positive, but their sum is minus 8. Can you find any two positive terms have some negative? No, we cannot have. Or two positive terms sum is negative, that is not possible. This is possible if and only if one of them is positive, other is negative, or both of them are negative. So if I can write this as minus 12 and minus 1, minus 6, minus 2, minus 2, minus 6, right? And minus 3, minus 4, minus 4, minus 3, then this is possible that their product is also 12. But their sum should be equal to minus 8, right? So minus 12 minus 1 is minus 13, minus 6 minus 2 is minus 8. So that is possible. Either minus 6 minus 2 or minus 2 minus 6, both can be written. So here what I can write for this question is x square minus 6x minus 2x, that would be minus 8, plus 12 is equal to 0. So if I would take x common, x minus 6 will live. If I took x common, x, but remember, this is a very fact. Usually students get mistakes in this area, that whenever they took negative sign common, they won't change the sign inside the bracket. Whenever we take negative sign common, then sign inside that will change. That will be minus 6 is equal to 0. Divide 12 by minus 2, that is minus 6. Now x minus 6 can be taken common, x minus 2 is left, that is equal to 0. So product of these two linear factors is 0. It means either x minus 6 is equal to 0 or x minus 2 is equal to 0. So x is equal to 6 or x is equal to 2. So solution set is 2 and 6. There are two answers, right? So I hope you got it. How to deal with such question? This is the fourth time. First, AC is positive, that is positive. B is negative, that is negative. And both the terms are negative. So whenever you analyze all this scenario, although I have taken a simpler examples, if you analyze all this scenario, it will come directly in your mind that where terms will be positive or negative. And once you will utilize all these things together, you will be able to solve questions quickly. Minus 6, minus 2, x has been taken, x minus 6. 2 has been taken common, x minus 6. X minus 6 can be taken common from those. Here x is left, here minus 2 is left. Product of two linear factors is 0. So in that way, this is either x is equal to 6 or x is equal to 2. So hopefully, you will be able to understand all these four types and solve some more question in the next classes. Some difficult question as well. So keep watching and subscribe our channel, Arvind Singh Academy, on YouTube. And also you can watch and visit our website www.arvindsingh.com for some